Hal, turn on the external camera, will you please? Hal Gurney, also known as Ernie Gurney. This is up on the 14th floor. This is looking across the street. That's 49th Street. Open the blinds, please, kids. All right. Oh, very nice. And this woman is working in the Briggs & Stratton building immediately south of us here on 6th Avenue. Her name is Meg Parsant. She works for Pocket Books, a division of the Simon & Schuster Publishing Company. Look at this woman's hair, Paul. Doesn't she truly? Yeah, she has lovely, lovely looking hair. I'm going to call over there, and we're going to see if we can't get Meg to help us with a little something here. Here we go. Okay, I hope I have not misdialed. That will be Meg Parsant. We met her about a year ago, I think, or 8 months ago. She's working late, as she always does. There, going for the phone, picks it up, and now
Hello,
saying...
Publicity.
Hi, Meg, it's me, Dave, over here at NBC.
Hi.
How you doing? Turn around and wave to America. Meg, don't let me forget something. Before we hang up, before we get off the phone tonight, get everyone there on the floor you work with and introduce them to us. Will you please?
Okay.
Meg, how have you been?
I've been doing well.
Are you holding up under the pressure of the holidays?
Yeah.
And do you have big plans for the holiday itself?
Well, I'm having Christmas brunch at my house.
Oh, brunch is nice. Now, what technically speaking do you serve for a brunch?
Well, I think I'm going to have lox and bagels.
Lox and bagels sounds very nice.
Not traditional, but it's okay.
Uh-huh, sure. And will there be Bloody Marys?
Well, there could be.
Mimosas?
Possibly.
Yeah. So you really get some heat on before noon is what you're trying to do, right?
Oh, yeah.
and will Tony, your boyfriend, be involved in this?
No, he's going up to be with his family upstate.
Oh, now, does that kind of rub you the wrong way?
No, it's okay.
You don't mind Tony's going away?
I think it's okay.
Has this Tony thing cooled off, Meg?
No.
Oh, okay. Hey, Meg, you know, your friend that, what's her name, the woman who had her hair washed over there?
Tara.
Yeah, she was here one night.
Oh, she was?
Yeah, she came over and saw the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, she seems like a lovely woman.
Yeah.
And she had lovely things to say about you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but you're not crazy about her, are you?
We don't really know each other that well.
Yeah, well, that's not quite how she explained it, but let's... all right, Meg, you know, do you have any idea why we're calling?
Other than just to say hello?
Well, no, normally yes, that would be plenty, and we would love to do that, and certainly anytime you want to chat, I'll be happy to talk with you. But tonight,
okay. Tonight
we have on the set for the first time this season our Christmas tree.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, and we thought you could help us with the lighting of the tree. Do you mind doing that?
Not at all.
Oh, okay, here's our tree here, right there, and as you can see, it's beautifully decorated, but we have not switched on the electric lights yet. So Hal, is Biff over there with the switch for Meg?
Go on, Biff.
All right, this should be Biff Henderson. Okay, there he is with the switch. All right, Meg.
Yes.
All right, just take the switch, put it down there so we can see it in the windowsill. That's good.
Okay.
All right, now put on those insulated gloves.
Right. Right. Oh, okay.
Okay, now be careful.
Okay.
You're not standing in any water, are you?
No.
All right. Now, Hal, let's see the tree here in this shot and see what this looks like. Okay, oh, this is beautiful. All right, now, Meg, and I think we need to dim the lights here so we can see what the tree looks like. Okay, very good. Now, Meg, I'll tell you what, at the count, I'm going to count down from three, and when you hear me say one, then you say Merry Christmas and throw the switch, okay?
When you say one?
Yeah, I'll count from
that?
Three down. You
want
to just practice one?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
No, but
don't throw the switch.
Okay.
3, 2, 1.
Wait, is this practice?
That was practice.
We don't need to practice.
Okay, all right. Hang on. Let's practice one more time. This is practice.
But
don't throw the switch.
I'm not going to throw the switch.
No. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Merry Christmas.
Okay, that's perfect.
Okay.
Now this time, it will be for real.
Okay.
Okay, the lights are dim. The tree is ready. Can we have a drum roll, Anton? All right, Meg, here we go.
Okay.
Lighting our 1990 Christmas tree. 3, 2, 1.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you very much, Meg.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas.
I love all of you guys. From From the home office in Lebanon, Pennsylvania, tonight's category for the top 10 list, top 10 promotional slogans for the suicide machine. Suicide machine, you know, Paul, a Michigan doctor devised a machine by which people, if they chose to, in dire circumstances, end their own life. And he's here now, top 10 promotional slogans.
For the suicide machine.
If they were to market such.
Ooh.
Here we go.
Perfect for this time of year, too.
And, of course, the same can be said of your hat. Okay, here we go. I'm sorry. It's a lovely hat. It looks great. I can't stop doing it. You understand? Yeah.
Okay. I know.
Here we go. Number 10. Top 10 promotional slogans for the suicide machine. Just try it once. That's all we ask. Number 9. Number 9. The quicker put her downer. Number 8. Isn't it about time you took an honest look at your stinking, miserable life? Number 7. Well, number 7's a little bit better. From the people who brought you the clapper. Number 6. Number 6, impress the chicks in hell. Number 5, Klaus von Bülow says, I liked it so much, I bought the company. Number 4, while I'm killing myself, I'm also cleaning my oven. Well, that's kind of cute. And number 3, damn it, it's time you did something for you. Number 2, if you're not dead in 30 minutes, it's free. And the number 1 promotional slogan for the suicide machine, we're not the heartbeat of America.